Welcome to a very special event at our school, a very traditional assembly to farewell our Year 12s. And can I please introduce, and can everyone give a big round of applause to our class of 2023. Please be upstanding for the singing of the national anthem.
Bye.
Thank you, students. Thank you, everyone. We have two very special student counsellors as MCs today, Jacob and Erin, and I'll ask Jacob to begin proceedings.
Miss Kate Wilson, Principal of Kent Street Senior High School. Miss Marilyn Harvey, Manager of Corporate Services. Miss Helena Reichel, Mr. Craig Lynch, and Mr. Phil Harvard, Deputy Principals. And Miss Julie Miller, Year 12 Partial Care Coordinator. Welcome to the final assembly for our school to acknowledge the class of 2022, who have made an enormous contribution to the Kent Street community. This assembly is the penultimate ceremony for the Year 12s, as tomorrow they will have their presentation ceremony at Curtin Stadium. Miss Wilson, our principal, will now address the school and this year's Year 12 students and conduct the acknowledgement to country.
Good morning, everyone. Before I begin, I wish to show my respect and acknowledge the traditional custodians, elders past and present, whose cultures and customs have nurtured and continue to nurture the land upon which we meet this morning, Wadjuknongar country. I also acknowledge and warmly welcome the parents and guardians and family members of our Year 12 students. This is as much a celebration for you as it is our graduating class. This is a very proud moment for you as you watch your children reach a landmark occasion, and we are absolutely thrilled COVID-19 has not prevented you from joining us this morning for this special occasion. Today is a great celebration for the graduating class of 2022. We celebrate and acknowledge the success and hard work that has gone into successfully completing 13 years of schooling to date. For our Year 12 students, it is the culmination of years of hard work, the actualisation of goals attained, and the acknowledgement of successes achieved. It is also an occasion that evokes different feelings and emotions. Excitement in anticipation of beginning a new chapter in life. Sadness in leaving a place that has nurtured you for 6 years. Trepidation in contemplating what lies ahead. For some, there may be regret what could have been. And for others, joy and satisfaction for what has been achieved and what will be in the upcoming exams. Our Year 12 students have reached a significant milestone in their lives. A milestone all of you sitting here today are encouraged to aspire to achieve. With considerable guidance and support from both home and school, our Year 12 students have reached this milestone, and with the same guidance and support that is available to each and every one of you sitting here today, you are capable of the same achievement. I ask you all to consider what it means to succeed and what that will mean for each of you in the years ahead, as you too set your sights on this significant milestone, the completion of Year 12. Regardless of what your endeavours may be, the future is yours to take advantage of, and Kent Street Senior High School will offer countless opportunities. How you choose to view those opportunities is up to you. To the graduating class of 2022, congratulations on an amazing year, in more ways than one. Your resilience, adaptability, commitment, and genuine care for one another has held you steady during continuing uncertain times and tragic losses that will bond you all for life. You have demonstrated your ability to embrace and transform challenges into opportunities and triumphs. And I thank you for the inspiration your achievement will provide the students who sit before you today. I hope you are truly proud of your achievements through Kent Street Senior High School. Your graduation is a wonderful achievement that in time you will look back on with pride. Ensure you take a moment today to reflect and enjoy what was and consider what may be. I look forward to presenting a more personal address tomorrow evening. Until then, I wish all of our ATAR students all the very best as you enter the exam period in the coming weeks, and all other graduates every success as you consider your next steps and opportunities as of next Monday. Please join me in acknowledging the 2022 Year 12 graduates.
Thank you, Ms. Wilson. Ms. Rachel, our Senior School Deputy Principal, will now address the school and this year's Year 12 students. School's crest was designed and adopted. The motto courage and the crest, which contains not a cross but a spanner and a steel spike, which were representative tools and that reflected the times. Courage has been recently updated to courage to achieve, but the crest has not changed. So almost 6 years ago, you all converged on Kent Street Senior High School from various primary schools as fresh-faced and eager youngsters to commence your secondary schooling. Along the journey, we welcomed others and sadly lost others. Let us stop for a moment to remember Riley and Dale. Continuing your formal education at Kent Street may not have been a choice for you, as it was your local school. For others who chose Kent Street, as it offered you the opportunity to pursue your interests and further your talents in aviation, cricket, or fashion and design. I doubt very much that you chose Kent Street because of the school's motto of courage. However, over the years, we have made reference to our motto, courage, or courage to achieve, to help you to reflect on your practices, achievements, and experiences to develop this character trait that will hold you in good stead. Have we been successful in this principle, we might ask? I think we have. What does it mean to be courageous, you may ask, and you may even ask this question of yourself. Am I courageous? A courageous person is not the loudest, or the strongest, or the most daring, or even the most extrovert. Some song lyrics portray the roaring lion or the eye of a tiger as being symbols of courageousness. Know that courage comes in many different guises. In the words of Marianne Radmacher, courage doesn't always roar. Sometimes courage is the quiet voice at the end of the day saying, I will try again tomorrow. We dream, we plan, and sometimes life throws these plans into chaos. It is at these times that having the courage to work through the chaos, refocus, recommit, as you so capably demonstrated and maturely did so during the year, this is the positive way forward. Plans and dreams that you have for yourself are yours, as you have the power and you are the author of your destiny. Achieving success is up to you, as motivational speaker Ziglar once wrote. In your hands, you hold the seeds of failure and the potential for greatness. Your hands are capable, but they must be used for the right things to reap the rewards that you are capable of attaining. The choice is yours.
Deep within each heart, there lies a magic spark that lights the fire above the dream.
too as you journey on. I hope you can listen to the lyrics to that song and reflect on why I chose it for you. So on the day you were born, your flame for learning was lit. Over the years, this flame continued to burn as you acquired knowledge and skills. I ask you to continue to fuel this flame, to have the courage to engage in learning, to reach outside your comfort zone, challenge yourself, build your knowledge, and feel the flame forever burn. Having the courage to embrace and overcome your fears, challenges, and any curveballs that may be thrown your way with an I can attitude is our hope for you all. So almost 6 years ago, most of you converged on Kent Street and became the Year 7 students of 2017. Today, as a graduating class of 2022, you are about to diverge to forge a new path towards your personal, social, and economic dreams. Know that you are strong, know that you are capable, and know that you have the power to cause your destiny. As you move beyond school, continue to be courageous in your pursuit to learn and achieve, in knowing and being who you are, in knowing what you stand for and what you won't, in standing up for what you believe in, and in having the courage to be the person that you can be proud of. Visualise, if you may, the tools on our school crest, the spanner and the metal spike, which were symbolic and representatives of the world at the time. Replace these with three R's. These are our values: respect for self and others, responsibility to self and community, and finally, resilience to face your fears and the courage to try again. I hope you can embrace this image and the school's motto and use these as a tool to guide the manner in which you move forward. So soon you will walk out the door of the gym for the very last time as a student, but you will always be a Kentian. So on behalf of the Kent Street School community, I offer you our congratulations, best wishes, good luck, and au revoir. So I present to you the graduating class of 2022.
Generates enormous pride and respect amongst staff and students. Our representatives this year have been exemplary in their duty and should be congratulated for their hard work. Can I ask Emma Christensen and Ian Lastrulia to give an address to the school on behalf of the class of 2022 and then announce the head boy and head girl for 2023?
Good morning, parents, guests, staff, students, and the class of 2022. My name is Ian, and this is Emma. It is our privilege to be standing here to deliver our final address on behalf of both the Student Council and the class of 2022. For most of you, this might just seem like another assembly you do every year. Instead, take it as a sneak peek into what lies ahead. I remember being in your position for the past 5 years, watching all the Year 12s take their final walk down that aisle to finish their time here at school. I remember each year slowly moving to the back of the gym as we walked through our high school journey. Last year, it dawned on me. We will be doing that very same walk down that same aisle to conclude our journey here at school, and today is that day.
In our last years, or even our last 2 weeks, we finally grasped what it's like to have our school life go by in a flash. It's so weird to think back to when we first entered high school, when we all probably had that oversized turtle shell of a backpack for the first day.
Maybe you're at Kent Street in year 7, or maybe you're in another school, another city, or another country. No matter where we were, we all knew there would be many long years before we would graduate, and now only one more day. Finally, it feels like it's all coming to an end. And what better way to conclude than with a final gathering, being surrounded by all our peers. It is clear we have all come such a long way.
Your time here at school will go by quickly. And as you go through high school, rushing on to the next task, don't forget to stop and live in the moment. There will be instances where you will be having the time of your life, whether that's skipping class to play music with your band or messing about in class while the teacher has turned away for a second. Live that second and enjoy it. While it might not seem like it now, these years in high school are the good old days you'll be referring to in the future. So make the most of it. Make the most of your time here before you go out into that scary place we call the real world. School is not just a place for you to learn how to find the equation on a curve. It is a place for you to learn how to grow up, where you will learn how to choose, make, and keep friends. You'll learn how to do things you don't want to do at times, but have to. And most importantly, you'll learn how to make the best of a bad situation. You are in what is possibly the best period of time in life, being happy, free, confused, and lonely at the same time, and in the best way possible. So don't linger on the feeling of having to drag yourself to school every day. This is where you'll be spending a significant amount of time, so I encourage you to make the most of every single moment here.
This time last year was the first time I got to speak in front of the school assembly, and the first time I represented the student council as head girl. I do want to specially mention our student councillors because they are some of the most motivated, ambitious, and hardworking group of people. It's been great fun being involved in the sausage sizzles, helping out in fun events and school activities, raising money for innovative causes, and even the presentation evenings. So if you're heading to Curtin tomorrow night, just know that a lot of work goes on behind the scenes, much of which is made possible by Ms. Tyler, the student council, not to mention Mr. Lynch, Mrs. John, and Ms. Miller. I would highly recommend being involved yourself, so definitely give it a go if you're up for the opportunity. Sure, year 12 is not always a joyful time. Exams, essays, breakouts, breakups, parents and teachers asking you what you want to do when you graduate, you're dealing with a lot. Sometimes it takes hours of sitting and forcing yourself to write anything, willing for words to spill out onto the screen so you can finish the essay and go to sleep. Sometimes, many hours later, after everyone else has gone to bed, it's still just a few hundred words into the 1,000 word limit. However, there are moments in your final years of high school where you just know you're going to look back and truly cherish this time. We've passed our last athletics carnival, our last assembly, our last period, recess, and lunch. We can remember our last school camps, our last educational excursions to Adventure World, and the last time we were surrounded by all our friends, classmates, and teachers. Planning what you're going to do once you leave school can be one of the most exciting parts of year 12, despite being extremely stressful at the same time. Now you can finally work or study in a field that you're actually interested in. Let's be real, it's probably not English. When we all get to sleep in, to catch up on Netflix, take trips to the beach with our friends, and everything else before we pretend to be grown-ups. This is the time to appreciate everyone who has gotten us to where we are now, up on this stage. Maybe they're sitting in the audience, maybe they're watching a recording, Maybe they're standing next to us or sitting next to us right now. And maybe they aren't with us anymore. I'd like to thank all the teachers, parents, family, friends, and relatives that have supported us through this, our graduation.
Year sevens, well done on making it through your first year of high school. You have completed the first step of an exciting journey. And for everyone else, well done. Well done on completing another year of high school. For some, this year will be the last time you enjoy the bliss of being in lower school. For others, this is the beginning of your toughest 2 years, having to navigate the joys of ATAR or complete the complexity of senior school. As you go through high school, you will face challenges, whether they be social or academic, and you will find very quickly that this isn't like the movies. The feeling of being embarrassed after messing up is normal. The ability to get up, dust yourself off, and have a laugh about it is a skill you want to have. There are also times in life when things don't go right, when you don't get the grade, you don't get chosen, or you don't win. I encourage you all not to forget them, because the ability to learn is a true gift. I can also assure you that within the past month, you've done something that you will look back on in the future and find it cringy and hilarious at the same time. I will tell you now, learn to live with the cringe. Because no matter how far or fast you run from it, it will catch up with you. Going through high school is no easy task. There are moments that are heavy and moments that are lighthearted. These are like pieces of luggage that we carry along with us. Some of you might realize that we, being human, cannot carry everything we pick up along the way. And it's up to you to decide what to hold on to and what to let go. Like Taylor Swift said, nothing safe is worth the drive. Don't be afraid to take some risks. Put yourself out there, submit that application you've been putting off, or take that leap of faith in starting something new.
Year 12. 14 years that have shaped your life in more ways than one. 14 years, and now it's game time. For the ATARs, your final waste exams have been a constant presence lurking around the corner throughout your entire senior school life. And now they're here. It's around this time of year we can start feeling exhausted, overwhelmed, disengaged, and maybe even burnt out. This is also around the time of year we need to prepare ourselves to perform at our very best and feel energized, confident, and capable. Sometimes this means getting a haircut or getting your nails done, and sometimes an extra hour of sleep makes more of a difference than an extra hour of late night cramming. Whatever happens after tomorrow, you will work things out. Once you finish your final year, there are so many opportunities to broaden your skills, build meaningful friendships, to travel, love, work, and study. Let the only thing that defines you be not your ATAR, but the sheer determination, willpower, and perseverance you show in this final stretch. You can all achieve whatever you put your mind to. The rest of today and tomorrow night will be a time to celebrate your achievements, appreciate your friends, and to look forward to when it's all over. And I hope we all have so much fun. Congratulations to the Kent Street Class of 2022. Pleasure to announce the head girl and head boy of the Student Council for 2023. Would everyone please give a round of applause to next year's head girl, Sylvia Blakeway.
please applaud the head boy of 2023, Jacob Bayros. Pastoral Care Coordinator, and Ms. Helena Reichel, our Senior School Deputy. Thank you for all your hard work throughout this whole year. We couldn't have done it without you.
Next year. Congratulations to our new head girl Sylvia and our head boy Jacob. Can I please ask Miss Wilson and last year's Jock Bremner Award winner Charles Carter Turner to announce the winner of the prize for 2023?
Was named after a science teacher who worked at Kent Street in the 50s and 60s. When Mr. Bremner passed away, his family donated a sum of money to be awarded to a Year 11 student who has successfully completed multiple Year 11 science subjects and will continue this science pathway in Year 12. May I ask the following student to make their way to the stage to receive this award? It is my pleasure to announce the 2023 recipient, Sharif Grave.
Wonderful contributions they make to our school. The first one is the Support Staff Appreciation Award, and the recipient of this award in 2022 is John Cottrell. John is extremely knowledgeable in all things IT and how things are done at Kent Street. He drops what he is doing with our prop and to assist staff and students with their problems, and we never have to wait long. During COVID, he was instrumental in setting up and running numerous webinars. He stayed after hours, did live streaming, and as you see, videos assemblies for parents who live outside of the metropolitan area. There would not be a staff member or student in the school who would not praise his work. We are privileged to have him at our school, as we know that he would be exceptionally welcomed in the private industry So it's fabulous to have him here, and it's an honour to acknowledge John with the Appreciation Award. Well done. Significant contribution. The recipient of the Rising Star Award in 2022 is Sarah Evans. Sarah? Miss Evans commenced at Kent Street just last year and was a breath of fresh air in the maths learning area. Conscientious, enthusiastic, Sarah's taken a range of classes with calm determination. She's kind and polite to her students. She's constantly seeking ways to engage with them and willing to try new strategies to make her lessons enjoyable and meaningful. Everyone feels welcome in her class. Students are in Miss Evans' homeroom are very fortunate as she makes homeroom a fun and interactive time and everything a homeroom should be. As a colleague, Sarah is friendly, helpful, respectful. If she sees a colleague who could do with a hand, she immediately offers help and will inconvenience herself to assist. She's the kind of person who, if she sees something that needs doing, she just steps up and does it without a fuss. Sarah, or Miss Evans, brings her generosity and enthusiasm to many areas of the school. She runs a homework club, which gives up 2 afternoons a week to provide students with an opportunity to get extra help with their homework in a safe and supportive environment. She served on the Aboriginal Cultural Standards Framework Committee. She's a passionate sports person and was a very valuable member in our Staff versus Students Year 12 games, particularly volleyball and netball, where she was best on ground as a very good goal shooter. Sarah is a very worthy recipient of this award. It's fabulous to have her at school, and it's wonderful to acknowledge her as our rising star for this year. Congratulations. Well done, Miss Evans. Finally, very important, our Rotary Meritorious Service Award. This is to acknowledge a person who has been at the school for a few years and has made a significant contribution to the school. The recipient of the award in 2022, and she's already been thanked, is Miss Stacey Tyler. Teacher. The arts were immediately impressed with her professionalism and positive rapport she created with her students. Stacey's flexibility has seen her teach across a number of contexts over the years, and she's always shown great enthusiasm and willingness to learn a new curriculum and create engaging lessons and resources for the young folk at Kent Street. She's passionate about the arts and works collaboratively with her peers in that learning area. The biggest asset to our school is her caring attitude and commitment. Since her commencement at Kent Street, Stacey's been an active staff member facilitating Follow the Dream homework classes, and her passion for supporting students both in and out of the classroom and has regularly seen her giving up her own time to photograph exhibitions, NAIDOC events, to name a few. She is very often one of the last teachers to leave the school, despite living many miles away, and it takes a great journey for her just to come to the school. Over the last few years, Stacey's been instrumental in the organising the yearbook, where her media, photography and design backgrounds have made it exceptional. This year, Stacey has simply excelled at overseeing our student council, and you see how appreciative they are for the work, and she's busy and in her work in planning for the presentation evening tomorrow. The number of times that she can be found at school eating her lunch at 3:30 having been committed to the whole day is numerous, and we acknowledge the work that she goes in, and I mentioned how far she has to travel just to come to the school every day. Ms. Tyler, your selfless service and attention to detail does not go unnoticed, and your nomination of this award is a testament to that, and we congratulate the meritorious award winner, Ms. Tyler. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
The Pastoral Care Coordinator is responsible for the welfare of the Year 12 cohort. This involves assisting students with academic achievement and prosperous pathway, attendance, behavioural, mental health and emotional needs. While this can be a demanding role, it is one that has an enormous personal reward, as you witness students flourishing and working hard to achieve their final schooling goal. Ms. Miller is the coordinator for the graduating class of 2022. Can I please invite Ms. Miller to the podium to make her address?
Thank you, Erin, and may I congratulate Sylvia and Jacob for their prestigious nominations next year. I look forward to working with you. Okay, so Year 12s, this is it. And just for today, you get to look out amongst the students that you were sitting in the front row just a mere 6 years ago, and you thought the last 18 months went really, really slowly, but here we are today, and Yanosh is nodding at me because he's going, wow, that is actually it, and this will be the 11s next year. So just for today, you are going to actually reflect on the fact that from the very top, Ms. Wilson, the executive committee, and so many of your, in particular, homeroom teachers, Mrs. Lord, Ms. Gibson, Mr. Pascoe, and Mr. Hugo, round of applause, because they've had to work very, very hard this year to get you through, please. And Mr. Virgo, sorry. I know that you want to share this time with family and friends, and can I say I'm very, very proud of each and every one of you, because I know from the diverse backgrounds you come from just what a struggle this last year has been for many. We, as Ms. Wright has said, have lost people along the way. They have dropped out, and we've had a tragic loss. And Dale and Riley, of course, have been acknowledged, and no one's going to forget them, all of you that were incredibly touched. I just need to refer to the resilience that you have shown in realising that life must go on, and it will go on with or without you. So the resilience shown by so many of you needs to be acknowledged, and I would like to ask the audience to give these people a round of applause for what they've actually achieved. On that note, I'm not going to wax lyrical about anything. I know you want to spend this time with your family and friends, because just for today, this is the very last time that you're going to be in here, and you've gotten through all of those rehearsals. You look resplendent, and we are also very incredibly proud to say congratulations, graduating class of 2022.
Very special occasion. Can I thank, and what will happen now is Ms. Miller will lead off the class of 2022. They'll move up onto the oval and I'll ask, as the class lead, could parents please follow them out, and you're welcome to have a photo and take a photo on the oval. Students 7 to 11, please remain seated. But can I thank you for attending and ask Ms. Miller to acknowledge and lead out the class of 2022. Thank you. Let the good times roll in. attending our final Year 12 assembly, and again I thank students for, when everyone's listening, for their excellent behaviour.